Let's take a look at the region in question that we're going to rotate around the y-axis. A graph of 1 over x to the fifth looks something like this in the first quadrant. Y equals 0 is the x-axis, x equals 1 is this vertical line right here, and x equals 6 is this vertical line. So the region in question looks something like that. Now if we want to rotate this around the y-axis, you'll notice that using the disk or washer method is not very convenient. I actually did a problem like this previously, where we had to split up the volume integral into two pieces. One piece, where the inner and outer radius were given by these two functions, and another piece where the inner and outer radius were given by these two functions. We don't want to have to do that in this problem, so we're going to use another method called the shell method. The shell method allows us to slice our region this way if we're rotating around the y-axis, and when we take that region and rotate it, you'll notice what we get is a big cylindrical shell. The width of the shell is dx, and if we add the volumes of all of these shells together using integration, we will get the volume. Now this volume that we find is the same volume that we would have found using the washer method, but this might be a slightly more convenient integral. So let's try it out. The volume of each one of these shells is just going to be the surface area of the shell multiplied by its thickness dx. The surface area of a cylinder is given by the formula 2 pi r h, and again, its thickness is given by dx. The radius of this shell is just given by whatever x value you choose between x equals 1 and x equals 6. So when we're rotating around the y-axis, that radius is just going to be x. The heights of each one of these shells, you'll notice, is dictated by this function 1 over x to the fifth. So the height is going to be given by 1 over x to the fifth. Then we can integrate that with respect to x from the lowest value of x in the region, which is 1, to the largest value of 6, and we'll be all set. Let's simplify this thing and get ourselves an answer. X divided by x to the fifth is x to the negative 4. When we integrate that, we add 1 to the power, and then we divide by that power. We could maybe more easily write this in this form, and now if we plug in our upper and lower limits of integration, we're going to get negative 1 over 648 plus 1/3. Multiply that whole thing by 2 pi, and we're going to get 215 over 324 pi as our final volume. That's in units cubed, and that is going to do it for that problem. I'll see you in the next one.